I just tell you, 28 minutes, then I appear on the screen, and this is for you an information that you have 2 more minutes, either to go to conclusions or to continue your talk, but 30 minutes, please. Okay?
Okay.
Thank you. The stage is yours. Please go ahead.
So, can you see my slide?
Yes, we can.
Yeah. So, the previous...
Make full screen would be better.
That's it. The previous talks were already of the star results, and mainly star now working with at low energy range, practically at the same range as the future collider NIC will be work. And I just want to remind you some slide about QCD phase diagram and where is the NICA lie in this QCD phase diagram. So NICA will go lower than RIC, lower than SPS, and but higher than future C100s and AGS. So we will work at the problem. Practically, this star dim energy scan at low energy, and our data must be the same or will be tested by the star data. And till now, you know that we don't know where is the point, critical point for the phase transition. So this is theoretical prediction in 2006. And some theoretical prediction of the signature of plug gluon plasma. And you know that all this theoretical signature was very studied very well at AGS and in other experiments, but till now we still don't know where the critical point is. Then from 2005, STAR starts the energy scan at low energy. You see this cover of the STAR preprints and the task which must be studied in the STAR beam energy scan. You see also fixed target program and so on. And now STAR already have finished this beam energy scan one, and now they worked with the data from beam energy scan two, some data available from this two, and many, not too many, not enough to good statistic, but this one data are available for the physics analysis. And main physics analysis was already discussed from the previous reports, and the main results till now, this is the study of the net proton distribution. And you see that net proton distribution in the events go to the larger number, but with the decreasing of the energy. And this is very well explained, except the energy at uh, 14.5, because it comes in the wrong way. But all other way of this distribution could be explained, because we don't have enough antiproton in the low energy, so the number of net proton increased with the decreasing of the energy. So it's understood very, very well. Then we need to study in more detail this distribution. We need some go to the more sophisticated analysis of the distribution, and we go to the high momentum of the distribution, and the high momentum of the distribution, you see that in peripheral events they didn't change practically, but for central events high moments of the distribution increased with very large, and so we need to check this, and also we need to decrease the error bar, and study with more attention the central events. So we need a huge statistic to study such signature. And again, because this high momentum distribution comes to the experimental analysis from the QCD models, this is because the ratio of some momentum gives us skewness and also kurtosis of the theoretical distribution, and it's very important to compare it with a theoretical model, and now we see that theoretical model didn't work very well now, and moreover, again, we need more statistics to study or to find some new physics in such distributions. So we go with this analysis. Also, main efforts to find new physics or find critical point for QCD phase transition comes from the study of the flows, for direct flows of particles. And you see now the excitation function for the direct flow of different particles, for hadrons, for mesons, and also for nuclei. So this is function, again, they have very large errors, and again, need to more statistics and to find some patterns in the behavior of this distribution. So this is the task of the NICA will be. And also NCQ scaling, so-called is number of quarks in the particles has difference with at low energy, and we see that again some particles needs to study more carefully, and also we need to study this scaling at NICA energy. So NICA energies will cover two energies from the star experiment we will cover. And net flows comes again for mesons practically at zero, and the difference between elliptic flow of particles elliptic flow of antiparticles grows with the degrees of energy. So, but again, you see the errors and so on. And a very beautiful analysis of high PT suppressions, and the high PT suppressions at low energy becomes a high PT increasing not the suppression, but increasing. And as you know, this is practically the so-called Cronin effect, but we don't understand why it is. Goes in the data analysis. So we need to study all this very nice signature and so on. And also at low energy, femtoscopic analysis give us different behavior for the radius of interaction or sources for the particles. You see that with radius increase with low energy gain. So it's at high energy, it goes practically at the same values, but at low energy, it increases. So why the source increase at low energy, we still don't understand now. So extraction function shows this very well and with good statistics. And with centrality of events, its behavior are well understood because we have more collisions, more sources for the particles, and this is behavior is well understood now. And for all these questions, we need to new facility, and as Sidorin says in his report, we have built this facility. We started to be built in 2007-2009, and soon we will start to work with this facility. The physics goal for the NICA, it was published in 2016, and it was the so-called white paper, and all many physics analysis were proposed in this volume of European Physics Journal. You can find this also on the web page, and it was a few papers which was concerned the physics analysis for NICA, also was published in the previous year. But now we have already collaboration last year. We join many people for collaboration of MPD, and now we have few physics working group. And the task for the physics working group is the study of global absorbables, spectra of light, flavor, correlation and fluctuation, and electromagnetic physics with electromagnetic probes, and also study of heavy flavor. And in detail, you can look at the task for this physics working group. Now this physics working group make some studies, and some results from this physics group I will show you just in briefly. So they work practically now with RQMD model and other model which I will show later. And the first task for global observables is the study of particle multiplicity. And now you can see the particle multiplicity and classes for different centrality of this particle multiplicity. So with a different energy, we have different distribution of particles and different classes, but now we make this separation of the events for with multiplicity. Also, the goal of the global observables is to make the trigger to distinguish between central events and peripheral events online. So with our forward hadronic collimator, we can separate these events, and online in the experiment, we could obtain trigger for the central events and peripheral events to study, because central events cover only 5% of the whole statistics. So to study central events, to obtain the good statistics for central events, we need to separate it online in the experiment. So we can make this with our detector. Then many efforts was put to study the strange and multi-stage baryons with MPD, and we have hundreds of simulation events with these particles, and this is results of reconstruction of different strange particles with the MPD and with the data which obtained in the first stage of MPD, only TPC, with usage only TPC and time of flight detector. So, and this energy and PHSD model with full reconstruction of the particles. So we have studied the feasibility of this physics with MPD. Also, we can work with femtoscopic analysis at MPD, and with this model, which predicts, which can simulate first order phase transition and the crossover phase transition of the in this energy range. And the femtoscopy gives us possibility to separate events or distinguish between events if we will have first order transition or crossover. So study of this signature femtoscopic for different radius, we can distinguish between these events. Then we can obtain results, or we can say words about phase transition in the low energy, which we will study in the NIC. So it's very nice analysis for the physics. And because, as I said, flows is a general purpose to study QCD phase transition, so we also have methods how to study elliptic flow with MPD and the data at different energies. This is example for this energy, and also direct flow. This analysis also was done, and even for first beams for the NICA, it was bismuth, and we have analysis at this energy and with these colliding particles. And because MPD will have the electromagnetic colorimeter also, we can study electromagnetic probes with this colorimeter. And we study the performance of the colorimeter to find single photon and with working D model, and also study the methods how to find pi zero with the colorimeter. And this is our results from this study, and we can so separate pi zero from the direct photon, and from the other decaying particles, and find the pi zero in the calorimeter also. So this field also was in our bags. Then, wait, with the second stage, in the second stage of MPD, we will have also inner tracker system, and you see this picture of the inner tracker system, and it is practically the same which Alice will use in his in its data obtaining data. And now we have simulation at our energy of decay, D zero decay and D plus decay, and you see the signal we can obtain for these particles we can obtain with this detector, but it will be future. And also we need beam and study this excitation function or beam energy dependence of different behavior of electric flow with different methods, which ratio of different methods also comes in not well understood way, and we will study also with this with this analysis. And again, with different phase transition, you see that different phase transition, this is crossover, this which gives this model, and we make also simulation for this analysis. Wait. But then all these physics results, I will skip this. Now the paper is prepared for the first physics analysis with MPD. And all this simulation analysis now we make preparation to publish this analysis of simulation, and it will be the first part of the first physics from the MPD. All this data which we used in the physics analysis, you see the table, how many numbers of events we used for the analysis. So you see that we use now hundreds of events from different Monte Carlo generator. And this year we make a mass production of this data, and now we have a good possibility to prepare physics analysis in a reasonable time. And in this task are very useful supercomputer Gavarón, which we used, and this is LIT PC farm, and practically now we can make reconstruction of 2 million events per day. And so give this performance give us the possibility to make physics analysis, reconstruction and physics analysis of the obtained real experimental data in the proper time to make reports on different conference. So we are ready to obtain physics, real experimental data and physics analysis from it. And a few words, as all this data and physics analysis which I show before, you see that we still need a new method for physics analysis, and I show you a few slides about physics analysis which was done by me for star experiment, and this is very simple idea, because anybody knows from the other branch of science that fractal dimension of the object is changes if you have phase transition in the with this object. And the simple formula for how to calculate fractal dimension and simplest method, so-called box counting, you just make this count the box, how many boxes are filled with it, by your object, and then study this value of fractal dimension. For our physics, it's very easy to see that we can make this physics analysis, because we have the distribution for transverse momentum, also rapidity. So it's, if you look at this picture, such physics analysis looks very nice to study it. And I was made this physics analysis with a star event at 2,200 GV, and you see that you have two dump in the events, and a different multiplicity, these dumps change this form and goes with some dynamics, you see, and also a difference with the energy of collision. Then to find out why we have such behavior of fractal analysis, I found such plot of the distribution of particles for PT max in each event. This is PT max, it's a maximum transverse momentum in the events. Maximum one, if one particle has this maximum transverse momentum, it becomes a global characteristic of such events. And if you put all events on such plot, you will see the picture, which is very simple for different energy, different multiplicity, and so on. And why it is useful, this picture? Because it can explain some effects which was proposed as a signature of the phase transition. For example, jet quenching, you see this different famous picture, and you see that at the gold central, you don't see the particles in the azimuth angle in different direction of the first jet. And if you look at the how they choose the trigger particles and also associated particles for this analysis, you will find that if you take trigger particles at this region, energy region, you couldn't find many particles associated, because this is practically empty space. And that's why, so it's explain this choose of such particles, it's explained with such these plots. And also very famous Rich effect of reach. And again, if you look at the cuts for the particles, you will find again the same behavior, because you took particles as trigger and study particles as this region below this. And so all, both effect, you see that was by different cuts, they study region of transition from these events, which is very azimuthally isotropic, and events with the jet or pencil-like events. Because in this sense, we have one particles with high moment, transverse momentum, and other particles with low transverse momentum. So, and this region changes with energy of collision, with multiplicity, and many others. So, if you both effects, you will find if you make such plot and will start to study transition region from these events to these events. And you also could find the flows on this plot and many other events, effects. So also I propose to study many particles events, no difference gold gore or even PP, because you know that PP ridge was found also in the PP collisions. And if you look at the choice of the particles, you will find again that you go in this transition region in the PT maximum plot. So this is illustration, because Pythia is a very good describes the behavior of the PP collisions at high energy. And I show this shoes of trigger particles for PP collisions and how they find the ridge in PP. First, they take trigger particles with high PT, but and look at the particles at this region where we have. I forget to say that these particles comes in the shows the flow in its behavior, and these particles show the jet. Then if you take the jet and also flow particles, you will see the ridge effect. And if you take these particles and these particles, you will see the jets very slow, very small, but you will see the behavior of the flow. And here you see it's different. If you took the particles with high PT, you will see very high jet from particles and also the flow from these other particles. And if you took the lower value of the PT, you will see even in this region, you will see the flow, because you took many particles with the flow behavior. So this is flow and this is jet. And with higher PT, you see more sharp peak of the jet and flow from the other particles.
Okay.
That's it. Thank you.
Please conclude, or because it's all.
So conclusion is that MPD physics group are ready to study experimental data, and also all our facilities are ready to make physics analysis, to find new physics, but to find new physics, we need also new methods. And many of such methods was proposed in the Nika White paper, and in the future, we will make this physics analysis, but now physics group are testing our software for analysis, our reconstruction software, and also detector performance. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you very much for an interesting talk. Although it took longer, 5 minutes longer. Therefore, I suggest that we shift all questions to the discussion session. Okay. Now, please. Okay.